These imposing mountains are this airplane's happy spot. Despite hot days and high elevations, its turbocharged Rotax 915IS pumps out a full 141 horsepower all the way up to 15,000 feet.
Its primary mission is to go off airport. Backcountry, obviously, is what our forte is as Kitfox, but the STI was tailored more towards the off airport operations.
And rough or short strips, or pastures, riverbanks, or mountain meadows, big tires and beefy nitrogen-charged shocks are made for them.
It basically offers zero rebound. You can plant the airplane on, and sometimes in a backcountry strip where you've kind of messed up the landing a little bit, but it's a short approach and no go around, you can plant it and it doesn't bounce back on you or give you a lot of feedback, so you don't end up floating down to the end of the runway trying to recover.
The tailwheel assembly has a shock absorber of its own.
It will absorb a lot of the energy that a standard spring or aluminum spring would give that feedback back into the fuselage.
And there's room for plenty of gear for backcountry adventures. The turtleback cargo area can carry up to 150 pounds. As you walk around the Kitfox, one of the first things you notice are the unusual second set of wings below the main wing. Those are flaperons, combined ailerons and flaps.
So a flaperon control, in my opinion, is more authoritative than a conventional aileron control. So when you input that control, you have a full span aileron that is detached and below the wing flying even through the stall. So it's very responsive in that aspect.
Responsive indeed. The roll rate is 60 degrees per second with the flaperons up. Control in all three axes is crisp.
The Kitfox is very responsive and doesn't take much control input. You almost intuitive, you think about it and it starts moving that direction. The rudder is very effective, which is good for your rudder control. It's a tailwheel pilot's airplane.
Performance is impressive. We took off from Driggs, Idaho with a density altitude of 9,000 feet. We used only 250 feet of grass runway before we were climbing at 1,000 feet per minute at 70 knots. And this STOL performer can drop into equally short runways or no runways at all. We used about 300 feet with no braking, but more aggressive technique can stop the airplane in less than 200 feet. There's a reason Kitfox is a top performer at STOL competitions. Kitfox has been building backcountry airplanes for 35 years, long before backcountry flying was widely considered cool. The Kitfox STI is an adventure machine for pilots seeking to test themselves far beyond the bounds of paved runways and fancy FBOs. In Driggs, Idaho, Dave Hirschman, AOPA Live.